my sis, Pre-Madonna in the building. Of course, she is currently on Love & Hip Hop Miami. We know her from the waist trainers, the Pre-Madonna cooks. Now, what kind of device did you drop over the holidays, Pre?
14-in-1 multifunctional pressure cooker.
Oh my gosh, sister.
I left yours at home.
How
you
know
I always bring gifts.
Oh.
But that's my way to, you know, kind of
we got to see each
house.
Other again.
Yeah, no, I know that's my way to make sure you get next.
I'm pulling up, and hopefully you got some of them Pre-Madonna cooks on the stove.
We're going to put in the pressure cooker real quick.
Okay.
It don't even matter. Oxtail's 45 minutes. Turkey's 45 minutes.
You took the game by storm because, you know, they had you in a box. You were, you know, had the Kardashians selling the waist trainers. Then, you know, people that you had promoting start selling their own undergarments. And then you didn't stop. You know, you kept, you started with the seasoning.
Because that's,
you keep in the cookbook.
Yep, you keep going. You can't worry about who doing what because you got lawyers for that type of stuff. But you just keep going to get your coin and focus on the rest of the things that you got to do and you're going to be all right. Because the thing is, when I was pregnant, Shy, I was like, I really can't put on a waist trainer. And I know that I am a person who sells more being a brand.
It's That's
like
right.
Everybody respects me and wants to purchase because of the brand. They want to see me in it and they want to see me promoting. I couldn't. But I was cooking and I was utilizing my resources and I was like, wait a minute, hold up.
Right.
So I was birthing a baby and then I birthed my pot. I had them at the same time.
I know, that's right. So a lot of the controversy, it seems, that is surrounding you and Jocelyn Hernandez, she came for you and she called you Miss Piggy, like just all these derogatory terms.
Yeah,
you
just Piggy.
Gave birth to a baby. And I'm just like, wow, like she just gave birth. Like, is she supposed to immediately bounce back from giving birth? I'm a little confused because how much, you know, time, we're only giving women, what, a year now to get their bodies together, 12 months, 6 months. What's the time limit? Let you heal naturally. She doesn't know what's really going on with you.
Right. You know, this is the thing. Ignorance is bliss, first of all. When you're ignorant like that, the first thing you do is you're going to body shame somebody.
Right.
And it's really unfortunate, but it's actually a good thing because I'm tough and I have tough skin. The only thing about it is if you're going to body shame me, a perfect 182-pound woman that wears a size 12 comfortably, I have no problem saying that. What are my other girls out there who wear 182 pounds that are wider than me going to feel like at home? You're going to really have the weaker people feeling subconscious about their self. Like, you're
right.
Not going to stop or hinder anything in my mind, but I feel for my gang out there.
That's
my
right.
job is to save the world one waist at a time. And when you mess with the general, I got to make sure my people going to be okay.
That's right.
The soldier going to always ride, but I have to make sure that my camp, my military base is going to be straight. So body shame is not cool, but at the end of the day, when you substance abuse and all that stuff in your life, you really don't know what you're saying. You don't know what you're doing. But my whole thing about it was, you know, you can't body shame anybody.
You can't.
I don't care if they just had a baby. You don't know anyone's circumstances. She doesn't even know if I could have been suffering with postpartum, which I did in the past.
That's
you
right.
You don't do that. And as a woman, a real woman body fluctuates. Even with the weight, I'm always going to be straight.
That's right.
So it doesn't even matter. It's just the simple fact of you try to be cute, but ain't nothing cute about it. It's just true.
You go on national TV, you try to, you know, pick your target because you know you're trying to get ratings. And I feel like after being gone for this long off of television, you know, she did a campaign once before when she was trying to push a record, like saying, oh, she's changed, her baby's changed her life. But no, you live through controversial headlines.
Not even trying to push a record. Even her trying to push a fitness company at one point.
Right.
How are you somebody who's trying to help someone lose weight? Now you're talking about other people's weight. That's not healthy and that's not natural. You can't just run around here bullying people.
Right.
See, everybody's a bully until you meet a bully.
Mm-hmm. Yep, and she got away with it for a long time, and she picked the wrong one because sis ain't walking here with her regular Pre-Madonna energy, and I'm like, hey, tell Pre to call me, like, you know, when this whole thing over. I know you are on, you know, just defense mode because Jocelyn is a brand that's been around for a long time, so she has minions, you know what I'm saying?
Here's the thing.
People that are trolling, people that are condoning this behavior that she's putting out there, and it's just not cool.
It's not cool at all. But you know, it's expected. And at the end of the day, I have a brand. They come on national TV and they try to build a brand. And if you feel as if you need to attack the bigger brand to get where you at, I understand.
Okay.
However, I'm not the one of the two. So you should have took a different route.
I think she didn't do all her investigations properly. Since you should have called me and I would have told you that Pre-Dot the one, because...
It's a time and place for everything, and I feel like, you know, you just gotta tune into the show. It's gonna be so much more going on. Gotta tune into Love and Hip Hop Miami. You'll get to see more of this story unfold. Hopefully the drama stops and all that good stuff. At the end of the day, like I said, it's nothing personal because she don't know me personally.
Right.
She's just figment of my imagination, actually.
That's right.
So I really don't pay it no mind because it pays me nothing.
I'm sure people are just tuning in. They like, who is that on the radio with Miss Shanika? It's Prima Donna. Love and Hip Hop Miami. Of course, there's a situation going on with her and Jocelyn. Jocelyn started...
The Puerto Rican peasant.
Started bullying. And now Pri has to defend herself. And I'm down for somebody showing somebody else that it is not a game.
Yeah, because at the
end... As long as it don't turn violent, Pri.
I'll tell you right now, I'm a businesswoman. I'm a mother. I have 3 children. I have nieces. I have a lot of people that look up to me. My first resort will not be violent. I'm not that type of person. However, I do let them know I am a rehabilitated criminal. What that means is if you put me in certain situations, I could relapse with the behavior issue. But I hope not, because we're not 14 and we're not 15. So, girls, violence is never the answer. Let's just be catty. Let's get it out. You duke it out with your words. And one thing about me, I'm just going to snatch the soul out of her. I don't have to touch her physically.
That's right. And I think the world is too, because I really don't think she considered the fact that the average size for an American woman is a size 12.
And let's talk about an African American woman who she portrays and wants to be and likes to copy and use for her benefit,
right,
when it's convenient for her.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't like the natural black woman. This is a natural curve from straight from Ghana, baby. This is what you call a Ghana body. You understand me? I can't help it that my weight fluctuates. I can't help that my arms gonna grow with my thighs and my waist gonna grow after pushing out a healthy 7.5-pound baby.
That's right.
I can't help that, sweetie. I ate pizza and fries. And my child was not deprived.
Okay.
I'm not going to apologize for that.
Hey.
That's... Shanika, you're getting exclusive.
I am. Thank you so much, Pri. I'm going to hold over a little bit, you know, and see what else she got to say. But definitely, DJ Hershey coming up, 5 o'clock traffic jam. It's Hot 107.